off.
Alright, so what's your time to beat in this game?
Not beaten yet.
Hold on. Give me a second. Oh my god. Please tell me the audio of our voices in there. Oh. Oh, okay, it is in there. Thank god. Why did Elgato turn off the fucking... Oh, thank god it's there. Alright, so... Let's see, actually, what the time to beat is, Vandia. I believe I wrote down... Hour 17. I could be wrong, but I believe that is my time. Might not be, actually.
Oh my god, now we're finally on the fucking last level.
Oh, you made it to the lab? Oh, you made it to Cortex.
Yeah, after like fucking, what, 15 minutes later?
Hour 14, Vandilia. Hour 14.
Alright.
Oh.
Okay. Well, since you're gonna do that, I'm gonna begin the Crash 2 speedrun.
Alright, the save when, the start button.
Yes, same rules as before. As soon as I hit start, begin the timer. And as soon as I say time, end the timer. Okay?
Okay.
Fucker.
Alright, here we go. 3, 2, 1.
You bitch, you made me miss.
Come on, shut your mouth, Cortex. I'm skipping your audio.
It's the Noid from Domino's.
What, Domino's Pizza?
Okay, here we go. The thing I like about this game better is, I didn't even hit the record button. Well, that's a reset.
Okay, so...
Fucking A.
Restart.
So, okay, listen.
Reset your timer.
Guys, listen. Listen.
Yeah.
So, when I hit time, I had to take, like, a few milliseconds in order to actually reach my hand out and press the stop button on my timer. So, the milliseconds 88 does not count because of me having to reach for the timer. But,
okay,
so, since that the milliseconds 88 didn't count, I got this game completed in exactly 1 minute and 30 seconds. Exact. Look, exact.
You mean an hour 30
seconds. 1 hour 30.
1 hour nice. And 30 minutes exactly.
You said a minute 30 seconds.
Do you got enough energy to do Crash 2 with me, Adam?
Oh, I can't fucking do it tonight. I'd fucking kill myself. I would basically get myself killed if I did Crash 2. There's no fucking way.
Well, then I guess just watch me, because I'm trying to beat my record of an hour 14.
Yep, and now there's 4 days, 22 hours, 7 minutes, and 41 seconds before the switch is released.
Okay, here we go. You guys ready?
Yeah, ready.
I'm gonna actually hit record this time, so, yeah.
Oh my God.
Look, we're back, you guys.
Whoa.
We're back with Crash 2, and we're gonna be speedrunning it again. So...
And I'm not doing
this time.
But this time, running this race against himself.
Yeah, this time I'm just doing it to beat my time, which I was essentially doing that the last time as well, but Adam was doing it with me, so it was technically a race, but not really. And we're capturing your guys' audio again.
Don't worry, I'm capturing my audio on my side, too.
Okay. Now that we got that fixed, your guys' audio is being captured, so say hello!
Hello, people of Earth.
So, wait, can I say my thing real quick?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, so, shortly before... Whoa. What the fuck is my computer doing?
Fucking up.
Oh my god, dude, my fucking screen is glitching the fuck out. Oh.
And Jesus, I got myself Christ. Some juice.
Brandon, my fucking get screen right. is freaking out.
Well, that's unfortunate.
Oh my god. Okay, is it done freaking out?
Anyways, I'm gonna start this and then you can continue your story. So, get ready, Vandelia. I have Vandelia as my timer, so get ready. Now we're gonna actually do it correct this time. Okay. 3, 2, 1, go!
Oh my god, I'm sorry. Oh, fucking hell. I don't know what the fuck just happened, but my screen just fucking freaked out for a moment there. Like, oh my god. It was like starting to go static, turning certain colors, and then... Or changing certain colors, and then it would go black, and then it would come back, and it would repeat the process a few more times, and I didn't even touch my computer. Oh my god. I'm actually getting worried because, fucking screen glitches happened on my computer before, and then, like, sometime earlier this week, fucking I hit the corner of my laptop so hard that it made my computer screen fucking just stop, and it basically made my computer crash, and I had to restart my computer, and then it worked fine, and now this happened all out of fucking nowhere. I swear to god, dude, I'm afraid my computer's just gonna die at some point. Wow. If that's the case, I need to fucking start getting my shit backed up, like, fast.
Time to buy some thumb drives.
I actually have a hard drive. So, I mean, mainly what I need to back up is all my video stuff. In fact, I don't even know if I did that already. I don't remember. All I remember is that I backed up, like, Adobe Premiere and all the other products, and I don't even know if that would work if I got a new computer. I never tested it, so.
I need to get Adobe one of these days. I need to buy it one of these days.
Well, I'm afraid, though, because I don't want to have to pay for Adobe Premiere, and I already have all the Adobe products for free. So, God forbid, if my computer crashed so bad that all the data got lost, and me backing up the Adobe products doesn't work because the software just refuses to run or something, then I am royally fucked. I would be royally fucked. I would be done editing videos because I just don't have proper editing software at that point. And also, fuck Movie Maker. That shit pisses me off now.
Yeah. Hopefully you get it working because that's a ten.
And I did that on purpose.
What, Vandelia?
Hopefully you get fixed soon, because otherwise, that's $10 a video you're losing.
Okay, let me explain what I was going to say earlier before my computer decided to fucking be scary on me. So, shortly before Brandon started recording this video, from the last speedrun video he made, I still had to continue the game. Eventually, I actually did manage to get to the final boss fight. I defeat Cortex, and since I was using a physical stopwatch, I had to reach my hand out towards the watch in order to actually stop the time properly. So, milliseconds that are on the actual timer do not count, because those milliseconds represent the amount of time I had to have my hand go from my controller to the actual timer. And by the way, in case anyone's wondering, the milliseconds were 88, but 88 milliseconds don't count. So, since they don't count, that means I completed the game in exactly 1 hour and 30 minutes, which is like a half hour past Brandon's, I think.
I got like a minute 13-ish. What was the exact time, Vandelia?
I'd look it up.
Oh, yeah. So, that's why I did.
I forget the
A minute. Minutes. No, an hour and 30 seconds exactly.
Video's still processing. I can't look at it.
Gotcha. Well, the exact time was like an hour and 13.
It was 3 minutes slower than your last your record time.
Yeah, and that was an hour 9.
About hour 12.
Yeah.
I remember that point. It was 3 minutes slower from your gold medal.
Shut up, Cortex. And yes, that was a camera glitch that I accidentally did.
Talking time with caffeine speedrun.
Is that what you're gonna call this video?
Maybe.
That actually does sound pretty cool. Talking time with caffeine speedruns.
We already did that, though.
Well, no, like, this actual video.
What? Wait, now I'm confused.
We're talking time with caffeine gang, and we're doing a speedrun.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, good, ice cream. Apparently, because I guess we have ice cream now or something. I don't know.
Don't forget to share.
What? Ah! Okay. Let's not do that again.
Yes. Death is bad.
There we go.
Drugs are bad. Death is bad. Can't do the Mackie voice. I guess Nick passed out.
No, I'm here.
Seems like it. Oh, you're here?
Yep. You're
alive.
Shnick.
I'll probably go for another hour, at least. 5 o'clock is why I usually work till 5 o'clock, so.
That's funny, because this speedrun is going to take about an hour.
I can't watch football for an hour, that you breaking shit. Aw, shit. I can't watch football for an hour without you breaking shit.
It's the snowball again rolling away.
Yep. Oop, and I fell down a cliff and died.
All according to plan.
Yes, that was all in my plans.
Really, this snowball reminds me of Winnie the Pooh, like, again. Like, from that second book. The big race. Checkpoint.
Ah! And I killed myself. At least in this game, I don't have to kill myself. Like, purposely.
Do you know the glitches in this game? Are there glitches?
Not really.
Well, that's just pure skill, then.
Pretty much, yeah. I mean, the only glitch that I'm doing is what you've been seeing is this really fast slide spin. Whoa, why did I jump sideways? Why did I do that? That made no sense. Okay, Crash, do your roll. Okay, now let's go. Okay, now we're gonna go fight Ripperoo.
Good. Good, my computer did not go to some bullshit blue screen of death mode, I guess.
Is Ripperoo cousin of Scooby-Doo?
Maybe. I don't know. You do your crazy thing, buddy, and explode your crates that you create with your feet.
Brandon.
Yeah?
You wanna know a weird dream I had last night?
What's that?
So, basically, I didn't see Shnick specifically, but he was, like, in the dream. I only heard his voice. I didn't, like, see him specifically, but the only person I saw physically was you in the dream, and I don't know. I guess my best guess of what or where we were was we were in Phoenix at some airport. And you were going to team me back somewhere. I don't know specifically. My best guess might have been Colorado. I don't know. It could have been
anywhere,
to be honest.
Okay, we killed Ripperoo.
As Nick was there, too?
Yeah, I didn't see him specifically, but I did hear him.
What the fuck?
I don't know. Maybe dreams are fucking stupid. And I guess I pissed Shnick off because I said that I didn't see him, I only heard him.
You hear any voices in your head.
Shnick.
Yeah, and at some point Shnick in the dream wanted to go swimming or something, I don't know.
What? I hate swimming.
Oh my god. What fucking thing do you not hate? You hate fucking chocolate. You hate orange soda.
Whoa, I like orange soda.
Oh. Wait, what was it? Strawberry? Oh, fucking.
I hate strawberry ice cream.
Okay, you hate. Wait, what soda was it that you didn't like?
Root beer.
Oh. You hate root beer. You hate strawberry ice cream. And you fucking hate swimming. Why do you hate swimming?
I don't hate swimming. I just got bored of it.
Oh.
How did that happen?
Because I had to swim every goddamn day of every summer.
Really?
Every day?
Yeah.
What the fuck?
In that water now.
What, are they trying to make you some fucking fish man?
Fish man!
And of course, they always told me you should be happy you're even at a pool.
Are you serious? Oh my god. Why do they tell you that?
Because that's what they do.
I only want to say this like once every summer. Or maybe twice at the most.
Well, here's the thing. When I was a little kid, I only went to that pool maybe. Sure, I probably went every day, but maybe only for a few hours. But then when my gram started working, and not every day, because my gram would sometimes just hang out at the bungalow or just take us to Kingston or something or shopping. Equally as boring, but at least I wasn't doing the same goddamn thing every day. Then she started working there. At first, it was only weekends, and she would go in on Fridays and do it, and then I'd have to stay there all day Friday, but then Saturday and Sunday, my mom and dad could take me home when I was done. But then she started working all week. 5 days a week, I had to be at that pool from 10 in the morning all the way to 5 in the afternoon.
Yeah, I get bored too after a while.
Yeah.
Wow.
5 days a week for like 3 months.
How old were you?
This started when I was like 9, 10 years old.
Yeah. It'd be different if you were a teenager. You're like, oh, hey, look, a hot girl over there. Yeah, puberty at that point.
No.
Damn it! I wanted the life.
You wanted the wife or life?
Fuck.
I wanted the life crate that I missed.
Oh, God, I'm fucking shivering somehow. I'm shivering because
God,
I ate ice cream.
Wanted a wife.
Yeah.
Well, don't worry, you still have time.
I mean, not now, but eventually, yes, I do want a wife.
Brandon, did you just not even hear what Vandelia said?
Yeah, I did.
Oh my God. Jesus Christ, man.
Why did he do that?
Wow, that was fucking funny. But yeah, Shnick, in my dream, you wanted to go swimming even though we were at an airport.
The Phoenix Airport swimming pool.
To be honest, it didn't even look like the airport resembled anything close to the Phoenix Airport that actually exists. No, it was just some fucking random airport automatically generated by my fucking brain. Or whatever the fuck.
The MarioTube airport swimming pool.
Jesus Christ. I think the only reasoning I thought in the dream of anything close to a swimming pool was like fucking, I guess in the dream I figured, oh, they must have like a swimming pool somewhere nearby the fucking
airport.
There are some airports that have hotels
God,
that
Brandon,
would
you
have
scared me by
pools.
Making me Brandon, okay, wait, Shnick, I didn't hear what you said, but I need to say this right now. Brandon, you fucking scared me because I thought my computer crashed. God damn it. What the fuck? Now's not time.
He was eaten by a killer whale. Shammy.
Yeah, I got killed by
Schnick's
well,
body
I actually
was
got
found.
Killed by a stupid statue.
Shamu ate him.
Okay, what did you say, Shnick?
Some airports have hotels that have swimming pools.
Hotel
Wait,
Mario?
Airport hotels and airports? What the
I know oh. The one in Orlando does.
Why?
Because what if people need to go on a flight, need a place to stay overnight?
Yeah, that's true.
Wait.
Very true.
I'm confused, actually. Wait, how does that work?
No, wait. They stay at the hotel at the airport that's part of the airport, and they just stay there until the next morning when their flight takes off.
Huh. I always figured that you could just, I don't know, sleep in your house, wake up, and then drive to there.
Well, what if you're on your vacation?
Or what if you're at the airport
well,
and
shit.
You get snowed in?
Well, I mean, all the airports...
Then your flight gets delayed. Simple.
All the airports I've ever been to never had hotels. Not Denver Airport, not Phoenix Airport, not an airport in D.C., or, I actually forgot one of the states that I had to go to, I don't remember. But none of the fucking airports I've ever been to had a hotel, so the thought of having a hotel inside the airport is beyond me.
I think I've ever been to an airport long enough to check for hotels, but I've been to my date in the airport, I've been to LAX airport, and I've been to Orlando airport.
All I know about airports is that you fucking just go there, you go through a long-ass line of security, you go through more long-ass... Well,
that.
Actually, no, wait, let me rephrase that. You go through a long-ass line to get into the fucking airport, like your ticket, to get in, to the fucking plane in the first place.
What the hell? Why did it boost me sideways? What the fuck was that?
See, Brendan, see, that's exactly what happened to me last time I played Crash 2. That is exactly what happened. Only I got killed by the freaking snowball.
I've never experienced that.
The last time I flew was in 1999, before 9/11. So I wasn't that big of a... Security wasn't that bad back then.
Wow.
I flew to L.A. to see Boy Meets World.
So basically, you never flew again because of 9/11. Or is it for a different reason?
Because I had no money to go anywhere.
Well, there you go. Hey, you'll get another chance at flying somewhere, Vandalia.
In the 6 months, I go to Florida.
Yep, except it's going to be different compared to your last flight years ago.
Way different.
Seriously, dude, you have to go through a long line just to get to your fucking ticket, and then you got to go through a long-ass line of fucking security, like, holy fuck, it's long. I think it, like, takes about an hour to get through all that shit. Which is fucking crazy.
You'll get triggered.
Yeah, I hope you don't get triggered down by police. Fuck me. And, what else? I guess after that, you fucking, I don't know, after security, I guess you basically just fucking wait until your flight is ready. And then once your flight is ready, then you go in the fucking airplane, you find your fucking seat, you put your shit down somewhere or up somewhere, and then you fucking wait for the plane to actually take off. And then when the plane actually takes off, then you gotta wait for the fucking, however long it takes to fucking get to your destination. And then you gotta wait. Okay, after that, you fucking gotta wait for the plane to land, and then you gotta fucking, wait for everybody to be able to leave, except at that point, you also have to wait for people to leave, so you can actually get your ass up and fucking get your shit and leave yourself. And then, after that point, I don't know, you're free.
To your return trip.
Oh yeah, also one other thing I want to mention. I don't know why, but Denver International Airport has like a fucking railroad system. I don't know why they have it. And I mean, I'll tell you this. I don't think it's useless. I just don't know what the purpose of it is. Like an indoor... wait a minute. Aren't you playing with D-pad controls?
Yeah, and I accidentally hit down.
Oh my god. That's terrible.
Yeah, that was my fault. That was stupid. Whoa, what? That was a weird glitch. Did you see that?
What happened?
I hit triangle in the cutscene, skipped, and then you saw the enemies just... like, quickly get into position and start.
Oh, wow. Well, anyways, so yeah, Denver International Airport has a railroad system, and I never understood what the purpose of it was. I knew that we used it for a reason, I just didn't know what the reason was, and I still don't know to this day, actually. Like, I have zero clue.
Oh, railroad system.
Oh, now you finally got it.
I think you said rail trail. I think you said rail trail.
Oh. Oh my god. Well, fucking... Well, one cool thing about my Denver... Or, not mine. One cool thing about Denver International Airport's railroad system... was when you rode in it, if you're like by a window, you could see like how do I explain, you know those fucking like wind things that are like kind of like toys. You blow on it and like the fucking wheel spins because of the wind. Yeah, the pinwheel. There's like fucking pinwheels in like on the walls inside the railroad system. So when the railroad flies by,
ah, fuck man, god dang it.
When you were okay, when the railroad goes past them, you'll see like fucking pinwheels spinning real fast. It's actually kind of cool.
Was that in your dream?
No, that reminds me. Actually, the sad part was that despite how long the dream lasted for, we never left the fucking quote unquote place. I don't know. We didn't even get on the fucking plane in my dream before I woke up. What?
So maybe you're all gonna come visit to Vandalia.
No, seriously, dude, my fucking dream didn't even get to go in the plane. It just fucking eventually ends leading nowhere. I don't even know what the fuck happened. Like, it was so fucking weird. Eventually, it, like, transitioned from, like, being in the airport to apparently me being in my apartment somehow. I mean, I guess we can mock it up as the hotel inside the airport thing or whatever the fuck. We could probably mock it up as that, but
that hotel is just, like, home.
A hotel room in the style of an apartment. Yeah, that makes sense. So cost effective. So, fucking, I don't know what happens. I mean, I guess I look for shit. I honestly don't even know. I mean, the way I can explain the dream was, what the fuck just happened? And why the fuck did we never get to go on the plane? And why the fuck did I not see Shnick in person in my dream? What the fuck?
Because you need to experience it for real.
I got the demo version where I can only experience your voice in the dream. No, if I want to see you in person, I have to physically go to where you live. Yeah. You know, that's kind of what I would do one day, but first I need to get back to Colorado.
Maybe
that's my first goal.
Maybe Snick was like, God, you hear his voice. I am Snick.
Oh, that's amazing.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, God that wants to swim.
How did I not see an aqua there? Okay, that was cool.
I'm sorry. Did you pass through two of those without taking damage?
I passed through one of them without taking any damage whatsoever.
How the fuck?
I don't know how that works, but it did.
You didn't even slide. You just fucking ran into it while spinning in the air. Oh, fuck. Oh, my God. I don't even know if I can say fuck off or just not anything.
And that's what you do if you have two Aku Akus. Just skip past those assholes.
Yeah?
Yep.
Do you think it's crazy that in Breath of the Wild, you're supposedly able to just skip through the whole game and just go straight to the final boss?
That'd be crazy, but you probably wouldn't stand any of a chance.
According to Nintendo, I think they said it is possible to actually go through the game like that. It's just really fucking hard, but it's possible.
Zelda challenge mode.
So has the Zelda fan base decided where that game takes place on the timeline?
What?
I think it's supposed to, like, go after some point. I don't know. Like, it's supposed to be sometime in the future. According to what I've heard.
It's apparently Apocalyptic's Hyrule.
Yeah.
Isn't there supposed to be some future elements?
Yeah.
There's, like Guardians.
There's that tablet you get at the beginning of the game.
So it's post.
The Sheikah tablet.
Yeah.
So that means it's post Ocarina of Time then, which takes place on one of the three timelines now. So there's three of them.
Yeah, post Ocarina of Time, where Link apparently failed to defeat Ganondorf. I guess that's my best guess because you'll see how. After you get the Master Sword, everything is in ruins as when you're in adult Link form, compared to when you're in Kid Link form.
So then it's in the Link's defeated timeline, which includes Link to the Past and Link Between Worlds and the original games.
Well, that's my best guess, but I'm not an official source. That's just my guess, honestly. Don't even take anything I say as official, honestly.
You heard it here. If Mario says it, it's canon.
Wait, what? Hold on. Wait, so am I getting paid for this now?
You think that was Nintendo.
Fuck.
It's canon. Okay, we're past the half an hour mark.
Oh yeah, I'll tell you that. You halfway done the game?
I believe, yeah. We're on Warp Room 3, so we got 4 and 5 to go. So we're a little over halfway.
If MarioTube says this, it's canon.
You know, it's funny because, Brandon, do you remember someone named, Lane?
No.
Lane Hunts?
No.
Oh, really? Huh. Well, anyways, yeah, there's a guy named Lane, and... there would be, like, a running joke where he would keep saying that I'm non-canon compared to everyone else in the group. Yeah, that's as close of relevance as I can get to this discussion. Oh my fucking god.
Okay then.
Yeah, I'm sorry. That wasn't much. I wanted to say something, I guess. I don't fucking... Look, it's 2:26 in the morning. I'm supposed to get up at about 9 in the morning. I don't even know why I'm not in bed yet. And fucking... I'm sitting here... talking about some shit that happened in middle school, and you don't even know what the fuck I'm talking about.
Usually don't.
Nobody knows what I'm talking about. I don't know what I'm talking about. Nobody and yet, knows. I know what I'm talking about. At the same time, fuck me.
Nobody knows the troubles you've seen.
Uh-huh.
I look a bear.
Yep, now I'm getting chased by a bear, which I'm really far ahead of now. Bear is still coming, and I'm already on the second bear. Oh, he just died. Uh-oh. Okay, we're good. Ow! Goddamn bomb.
You were saying?
Ow!
Brandon.
Yeah.
Bear it. Just bear it.
So this is like the snowball, but wow. With bears instead.
Yep.
Okay, I'm done.
Again, smushed or you'll get eaten if you get caught.
Yeah,
pretty much.
Hey, look, a mini bear. Let's go. Whee!
Baby.
Why are the
whole reason
bears
the bear's
geese?
Chasing us is because we hopped on its baby and now we're stealing it GTA style.
You have 5 stars.
Yeah, and now we just killed all the cops in one go.
Wow, that's pretty impressive. Did you use a cheat code?
It's called, I use the cheat code called PIT.
It's called the cheat code That Damn Good.
No, the cheat code Pit, it gets rid of all your stars. It makes you not wanted.
And now I'm gonna take a drinky.
Drinky? Alright, I seriously need to go to bed. I'm gonna take off now. Also, beat Tony.
Oh, you're not even gonna watch. You're not gonna watch Tiny.
Fine, I'll watch fucking you defeating Tony the Tiger, goddammit, from a fucking frost.
I'm gonna have to go
cereal.
Soon too, because it's like 5 in the morning here.
Tiny Toons. I'm good for a little.
No, Tony the Tiger, man. Come on, you don't want to fucking defeat it. What the fuck happened?
I don't know how he did that, but he caught me off guard.
I'm getting there by 30. I'm good for another 30, probably get another 30 minutes. It's 5 o'clock.
Yeah.
I usually work till 5 o'clock, so.
Well. I'm gonna be so fucked tomorrow. It's mainly because I wanted to have my own free time when I fucking had to go home at like nearly 11 in the fucking night because of bullshit happening at the cafe I
ready? Tiny's up. Gonna die now. Bye, Tiny! Uh-oh. Okay, there we go.
Oh, Tony the Tiger is dead, I guess. Tony. Congratulations, you defeated the Frosted Flakes Man. Or Tiger.
They're great!
Wow, nice timing.
Alright, yeah. So, is that all you wanted to show me, Brandon?
Yep. I just wanted to show you me kicking Tony the Tiger's ass.
Okay.
Because Tiny is dead now. And now Tony is dead as well.
Say goodbye to MarioTube, everybody.
MarioTube's
apparently dead now.
Oh, yeah, and also before I leave, there's 4 days, 21 hours, 29, 28 minutes, and 57 seconds and counting before the Switch is released. But by the time this video is released, that's going to be obsolete. Worst case scenario, when this video is uploaded, it's either going to be March 3rd or past March 3rd of 2017.
Oh, I'm uploading this video probably in the next 2 or 3 days.
Oh, thank God. Okay. Not all is lost. Alright, I'm going. Fucking hope to God I survive tomorrow morning. Bye-bye. Oh god, what was that? Bye-bye.
Ow! Bye.
Bye. And then there's 3.
Yep.
Unless Dick's gone.
I'm not leaving just yet.
Okay, and then there were 3.
Shnick sounds tired, though.
Yeah, I am about to go.
Oh, for those who don't know, over on Stick's channel, we just finished Harry Potter.
Yep, Harry Pothead. As my sister would actually say.
Wow.
We finished the Xbox version of Harry Potter. And the Philosopher's Stone.
Yeah, and there was no raping of Harry Potter.
And that's kind of
yeah, good.
I'm saying that.
I was right there and I died. Bah, bah, bah. Fatality.
I wonder if you get the British version, it's different at all. The American version.
The British version, all they do is change the title, change philosopher. All the dialogue, it says Sorcerer's Stone to Philosopher's Stone.
Oh! Okay, we're good.
Apparently, yeah, I think it's basically alchemy. Like, did you know apparently Isaac Newton was an alchemist?
Who used to be an alchemist?
Isaac Newton.
Oh, Isaac Newton, huh.
He believes in alchemy. The guy who discovered gravity and the laws of motion. I also thought he turned lead into gold. Well, like technically you can. All you do is change a few protons and neutrons, and you have some gold. Simple. Just like here, take out some protons. Add some neutrons.
I ran into the stone fuck.
Or reverse that. I forget which is bigger on the elemental table, and you have gold. That's how you make gold. It's all the atomic level. If that was possible.
Ouch! I did it too early.
I've been thinking of a new series that, besides, it's called Food for Thought, one topic I'm thinking about is the killing of the mushroom kingdoms. All of the mushrooms that Mario eats might be dead members of the mushroom family, like all the dead toads.
In the first game, it actually says that Bowser turns the inhabitants of the Mushroom Kingdom into stones and bricks. So whenever you break a brick in the original Mario game, you're actually killing a toad.
Yeah, you mean eating his head as a mushroom, as a magic mushroom.
Yep.
Death makes me stronger.
Ah, Mario, you're sadistic, buddy.
He's gotta be a sadistic if he wants to beat Mickey Mouse in the WrestleMania main event.
Do the Mickey voice and respond to that, Brandon.
I'm gonna kick his ass, oh boy! Oh god, I almost died there. Oh, that was bad.
Okay, now you do the Mario voice.
It's me, Mario, and I'm gonna kick a Mickey Mouse's ass.
Oh, what about boy, Arabian Mario?
Mickey Mouse is gonna fucking kill you.
What about Arabian Mario?
Arabian
it's
Mario?
It's me, Mario, from India, and I'm going to take your ass.
No, I'm talking about Arabian Mario from my crappy RPG. That's what you described it as.
Arabian
Welcome to India. My name is Super Mario, and I am going to kick all of your asses because I come from India. Motherfucker.
Look, a cow.
Moo! What was it, a space cow?
I don't know, you're from India. They love cows in India.
Yeah, now we're doing the super spin slide to get past pretty much all of that level. And I even got to damage boost because I had an Aku. Shnick is incredibly bored. What? How did that happen?
Skill.
And how did that happen? Oh my god!
I blame Shrek for everything. That's what Mario said when he bit into the Tootsie Pop, quote unquote.
I'm fucking this part up because it's Cold Hard Crash, the worst level in the game. And it's like fucking 2 in the morning, and I'm tired.
It's 2 o'clock in the morning, you're tired, and you don't have any chocolate pudding.
2:30 for you, 4:30 for us.
Oh, the pain. Angelica, we don't have any chocolate pudding. There must be a store open somewhere. Angelica, I'm not going out at 3 in the morning to buy you chocolate pudding, and that's final. Where Where's the chocolate pudding? We're at the ready-made stuff, and we got pudding mix. Stu, what are you doing making chocolate pudding? It's 4 o'clock in the morning. Why on earth are you making chocolate pudding? Because I've lost control of my life. Here's your pudding, Angelica. Oh, that's okay, Uncle Stu. I'm not hungry anymore.
Oh, that's just awesome.
Did you ever watch All Grown Up?
Yeah, I've seen some episodes.
Oh, I haven't. Apparently, I think there's also a series where they showed at least one episode where they showed Angela at preschool.
Oh yeah, wow. Preschool days. That shit. Oh yeah, there was one regular episode of the series that did that.
Shit.
Hey, so Angela and Susie were like translators. They could speak in both adult and baby language. Like they were like in between. They could understand the babies and adults too.
Yeah.
Like a translator.
Mm-hmm.
45 minutes and we're about out of the fourth warp room. This is turning out to be really well.
You think it beat your record?
I think I may beat my record if I don't do that kind of shit.
I think I can.
I hope I can.
The little engine that could.
The little crash that could. Oh, it's this fucking level.
So you guys ever read that story?
What story?
The little engine that could story. Besides the version that Snick told at the Tarzan level game.
I told the version from Major Pain.
You ever heard the real story?
Nope.
It's about this. I think in this, if I remember correctly, there is this.
Oh my god!
A train full of toys for kids over the mountain, and then the mountain's very high, and then all the trains look up the mountain like I can't do that. Other trains like can't do it, and one engine is like I can do this. I think I can do this. I did it. I made it. At the moral of the story, you're trying. I think.
Trying. It gets you somewhere.
And then the Major Pain version. Well, basically, Major Pain's a movie about a guy who's been at war for quite a bit, and now there's no more combat for him to do, so now he has to be a drill instructor at a military camp, and basically he uses. They comically show off PTSD with him basically torturing the kids with, like, these vigorous workouts and whatnot. Though it's all played for laughs, so. And at one point, when the kids are all fed up with him and they want him to leave, he's like, fine, I'll leave if you get me a trophy. So, and they take his order as them needing to go to the rival school to steal away their trophy. And so they all go on basically a black op to go steal the trophy. And like the youngest member of the group's not allowed to go because he's too little. So of course he storms off to his bedroom crying. And of course Payne sees him. He's like, what's the matter with you, boy? They won't let me go on the black op because they say I'm too little. No one ever lets you do anything. You're too little. And he tells Payne starts telling his own version of the Little Engine That Could story to inspire him. Though, once again, the PTSD kicks in and he gradually transitions into one of his war stories, which is pretty graphic. And, like, it's, like, very gradual.
A little
like
blood
he...
that could.
No, seriously, here, let me tell the story.
I think we originally told the story of...
We did it for KH1, and then I did it again for Chicken Little.
Yeah, to help Tarzan out his...
Yeah, because we died at the Clayton boss fight, and then I referenced that in the Chicken Little Let's Play, and I ended up telling it again for Mario.
So now...
Yeah, now you're telling it again for me.
Right, here we go. Ah, fooey. What about all them stories about the little people that do big things, like Little Red Riding Hood, them Three Little Pigs, Spike Lee, or them Little Rascals? You ever hear the story about the little engine that could? Let me tell you that story. Once upon a time, deep, deep in the jungle, there's a little engine that could, and he's chugging his way across the enemy line. Chugga, 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 toot, toot. This little engine's mission was to carry some AK-47s and nuclear payload over the mountain to a 2063 battalion. Needless to say, there was plenty of opposition. You think that stopped a little engine that could?
No.
Nope. No sirree, Bob. He just kept chugging along. Chugga, 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 chugga. Toot! Toot! Not even when they climbed aboard the train and popped out the eyes of the conductor. Blood and snot was dripping from his eye sockets. You think I'd stop a little engine that could?
Nope.
Damn Skippy. He just kept chugging along. Chugga, 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 chugga. Toot! Toot! Wasn't until... Charlie rigged a bunch of blastic explosives just as the little engine was making its way across the dresser. Boom! Explosion happened. Blood and guts and spitting asses everywhere. And Bubba come crawling out the back door. Both legs miss. Little amazed baby boy. And he comes up to me. He says, Ping! I can't feel my legs. And I say, Bubba, they ain't there. I'm looking down, and there's these little bloody nubs that are just kicking real fast like this here. And I say, Bubba, it's 30 miles to the nearest town. Unless you get up on your hand, unless you turn over and walk up on your hands, you ain't gonna make it. Then all of a sudden, Charlie was all over the place. And I had no other alternative but to blast my way out. Die, Pig, die! You'll never take Major Benson Winifred Pan alive! Bam! I saw you dance, my friend! Bam, 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 bam! So, what'd you think of my little bedtime story?
That shit's funny.
At the very end, it reminded me of the Flintstones.
Well, I had to stay quiet because I don't want waking up the whole house. But anyways, to be continued. I'll come back and tell you what Bubba uses a penis.
Ah, what?
Mario had a similar reaction. I almost made him mess up in his race. Efforts to catch up with.
What was my reaction?
Your reaction was like, rated NC-17 or something like that.
But to see MarioTube reaction, go watch the Chicken Little Race, and to see my reaction, go watch Snick's video of Kingdom Hearts 1. Probably, I think the title was Our Inspirational Story.
Our inspiration, the Sora.
Oh shit, 53 minutes.
Though, I don't think you had much of a reaction in the KH1 version.
Is that part up yet? Your Chicken Little part, race part up?
No, it's like towards the end. Unfortunately.
hopefully that will be up soon. If MarioTube send you the videos for that?
Yeah, he sent me all the videos. I downloaded them. I just have to process them.
Cool. Especially since we gotta get those videos uploaded before we start Kingdom Hearts 2 uploads.
Yeah.
I think that's gonna be your longest Let's Play.
Two, probably.
Your longest series to date, at least.
Well, that's surprising. I haven't died yet.
5 minutes till...
Usually this level kicks my ass.
Yeah, 5 minutes till an hour. Pushing the wall.
Ah!
Wah, wah.
Stupid fucking platform didn't let me go. Oh, wow. Okay, that worked out. Ah! Minutes. We're doing good. Didn't mean to do that.
Alright. Close to your record?
It's gonna be close. Maybe a lot less. Maybe like 10 minutes less if I can do this last few parts well.
Are you in the final world now?
Oh yeah, this is the final warp room. We got like 4 levels left, Vandelia.
Stay tuned, folks. We're going to the final wire.
Yeah, this is gonna be down to the bone. Oop. Well, missed the checkpoint. Whatever. We're gonna keep going on.
Checkpoint? Where we're going, we don't need a checkpoint.
Okay, there we go. We got the checkpoint.
Oh, yeah. I remember one response you had. After I finished the story, I was like, hello there, Clayton. You just missed a little bedtime story. And then you respond with, but where you're going, there'll be no stories.
Gotta get the
crystal. Vandalia, I'll be honest, I'm watching Power Rangers right now, because you notice the AVGN actually loves the show now?
Yeah. Which one are you watching?
I was watching I'm watching the first season.
The real first season or the remix?
The real first season.
Yeah. Remix sucks.
58 minutes. We're almost cresting an hour. The fuck is cresting even?
Yes.
Me?
Let's see. I may complain about this before. I'll do it again right now. First season remix. If they had just made the HD remastered version of it and make colorful, that'd be great. But no, they had to add comic books and Batman, 60 Batman graphics to it, because apparently they needed to do that. The actual new colors and the brightness was awesome, but no, that bam, zip, pow stuff, and it's like, this is the Megazord, in bold letters, like, no, bad Disney for doing that.
Yeah, that was like the final insult Disney put towards Power Rangers.
They did awesome.
Wow.
They did awesome with their RPM was awesome.
Yeah.
Line was awesome, but then they like, nope, let's ruin it. by doing the Bam Zip Pal stuff and remix.
No, seriously, like,
no!
Brandon, in case you didn't know, Power Rangers originally started under the ownership of a company called Saban. And it was airing on 20th Century. It was airing with 20th Century all the way up to Time Force in 2001. But then Disney ended up buying out 20th Century's Kids Network and made ABC Family. And in the process, they acquired everything Saban owned, including Power Rangers. What's funny is that Disney's original plan was to finish producing Wild Force, which was the final season the original Saban worked on. And then literally all they wanted Power Rangers for was for, like, Linkara goes into detail about this, but all they wanted Power Rangers for was for the reruns. But because there was such a huge fan base, they basically had no choice but to make more seasons. But they were doing everything to cut the cost. They moved filming to New Zealand.
We're apparently illegal to watch it in New Zealand.
Yeah, that's like the pure irony. The show is banned in New Zealand.
Are you kidding me?
Just like there's this one county in, I think somewhere in America, where they make beer that county or whiskey, and that's a dry county. You can't drink it. But they make it there. Some liquor.
Yeah, so they moved filming to New Zealand. They cut the special effects budget big time, from what I hear. Disney just kept saying, all right, let's make this season, then it's over. Oh, they want more. Let's make this season, it's over. And then finally they got their wish with RPM. Like, basically, RPM ends on an unresolved cliffhanger.
It does? I thought...
That they may or may not have... What?
It did. I thought it was a happy ending.
Oh, it was, but then they do like is the story really over kind of thing with someone closing a briefcase.
But still, RPM was I think RPM was one of the was a great way that it ended. It was pretty good overall. I think RPM was a pretty good season. Of the series.
Yeah, the series was originally considered done with RPM, and then of course Disney remastered the original Mighty Morphin Power Rangers into what Vandelia hates. But the original founder of Saban managed to reform Saban, and they bought the rights back from Disney, and now new seasons of the show air on Nickelodeon.
Yeah, what they did that good. Okay, I gotta say this. Megaforce, stupid.
Yeah, that's the thing. The Nickelodeon seasons have gotten a pretty mixed reaction.
And also, the same thing every season. They go, first it was Samurai, then Super Samurai.
Yeah, see, in the Nickelodeon era, now they do two seasons of every show. First they'll do just regular Rangers whatever, and then they gotta do Super Rangers whatever. Like, first there's Samurai, then Super Samurai. Mega Force, Super Mega Force. Dino Charge, Super Dino Charge.
And now whatever this new season is. I haven't even watched this new season yet.
I don't even know what it is.
But yeah. But so
the
far,
only the only thing I thought was kind of cool was how they brought back Bulk and Skull for Samurai, even though it's mostly just Bulk.
Landing platform.
Yeah, like, supposedly you see Skull like once or twice, but.
You see Skull on the finale. Where he picks up this kid. But anyways.
And then the only other cool thing was how they did like a mega crossover between like all the different characters in different seasons, though you only see a couple of their faces.
But anyways, the three seasons I hate the most of Power Rangers are stupidest is one, the remix season. Two.
Overdrive?
Yes, Overdrive. That's the season that got me to hate Power Rangers for 3 years. I quit watching Power Rangers for that season. And now Super Mega Force, maybe.
Isn't that where the Mega Crossover episode is?
Yeah, that big,
what the fuck?
The big final battle thing.
Yeah. Literally, the only thing I think that's kind of cool is how you see, like, pretty much all the Rangers Rangers from previous seasons, though only a few of them get to be unmasked, but the few that do get unmasked, they actually get the original actors back.
Yeah, I mean, but they never morphed. They didn't get the morph. Like, if they had at least morphed in that battle, that would've been awesome. But nope, they're like, okay, put them back on. Like,
To their very slight credit, doing the morphing sequences for every single character would have taken up half the episode.
Well, not every character, but just the ones that were on screen, the actor ones.
Oh yeah.
And then plus, the final battle was in that battlefield anyways. Plus, I think they could having that battle with all the alien armada could have been a great what's the word. Bridge into SPD, where you know all the aliens.
He booted me back into a nitro. Fuck you.
An SPD world will take place like in a few years at this point, like in 2020, I think 2024 is the SPD universe, where at that point, all aliens lived on Earth now and happy in love and harmony, and Megaforce could have been a great bridge to that, but they dropped the ball.
Yeah, well, you know, a lot of people thought the continuity was messed up by RPM until it was later revealed that RPM took place in a different universe. And then later on, the Red Ranger from RPM manages to cross dimensions into the main universe where Samurai takes place.
Yeah. And do you ever watch, before the series got canceled, Database Rangers Power Reviews?
No, I've seen Linkara's History of Power Rangers reviews.
You used to watch Database Power Rangers reviews version of the RPM...
Fuck you!
Megaforce crossover, RPM Samurai crossover.
Yeah. By the way, Vandalia, you know there's actually a Power Rangers PS2 game called Power Rangers Super Legends?
I did not, but now I do.
Yeah, it's basically a 2.5D side-scroller made to celebrate the 15th anniversary of the series, though the thing is, it was made back when Disney still owned it.
Well, Disney did have a few good shows. Like, I liked,
Yeah, like... SPD and
Dino Thunder was good, too.
Yeah, Dino Thunder everyone liked.
Shameful, just shameful.
I'll admit, the only two seasons I've watched all the way through are Time Force and Ninja Storm.
God, that was fucking disappointing.
But anyways, Vandalia, so basically the gimmick with Super Legends is that you basically get Rangers teaming up from different seasons that were up to that point. And the main villain's Lord... Like, basically... Omega Ranger from SPD, like a future version of the guy who like manages the Hall of Power Rangers where everything's historically documented, and then you get Lord Zed messing things up, and basically the guy goes around recruiting Rangers from the previous seasons.
Fucking goddammit!
Unfortunately, Vandalia, the first team you get is Operation Overdrive.
Fucking level can go fucking to fucking suck a dick!
Vandalia.
Evil.
Operation Overdrive is in Super Legends.
Oh, there it is.
God, there's so much fucking waiting in this stupid piece of shit.
It's in Legends, I heard you. I'm trying to...
Fuck you!
I'm trying to do something...
Okay, sorry. Then the second team you get is Lost Galaxy. Then third is Ninja Storm. Fourth is the original Mighty Morphin. Fifth is SPD.
Oh my god.
And then I have no idea if... And then six, you just take down Lord Zed, I believe.
Alright, there you go. I sent you the video of the RPM Samurai crossover review.
Okay.
It's pretty funny.
Huh. Oh, okay. Now I'm fucking up even more. Fuck you, you fucking piece of shit level.
I think Brandon's starting to get into a Dora freak out.
The last fucking level is pissing me off.
Wah,
too much
wah.
Fucking waiting. God, this is fucking bullshit. Get out of the way, you fucking platform.
Babies, kisses. What's funny is that the DS version of Super Legends told a completely different story.
I think there was one, I don't know if it's canon or not, but there's one story where they made Lord Zedd evil again or something. That's how the evil stupid guy from Overdrive was born, or something like that. That stupid villain Overdrive, Zedd and Rita's son apparently. Even though they are already good, even though they become humans again at the end of In Space.
Yeah.
Well, I loved In Space. My favorite season, especially
In Space is often considered to be the best season.
It was this end of the original canon series. Not the canon series, but you know where it was one continuing Ranger storyline from.
How? I slid into him!
I did that, even though they were connected through it past Rangers, that was the end of the, continuous story.
Yeah.
Let's see. Turbo movie was canon, but the other movie wasn't canon.
You know the AVGN admitted he liked the Turbo movie better than the original movie?
Yeah, so did I.
Yeah, only because he thought the CG in the original movie was... He said it was worse than PS1 FMVs.
No!
Shrek on Xbox, freak out.
Swear
Shrek on Xbox. God.
Fucking stupid alien!
Elevators take a long time. They take an extremely long time.
Oh, yeah.
But will this one stop ever? Really? Aliens.
God. Fucking finally.
Four of the Rangers.
Get ready for time.
Four of the Rangers were both movies. Which four they were?
What?
Here we go, Vandilia. Get ready for time.
Four of the what?
Four of the Rangers were in both of the movies.
I think the original pink and the
shave
original
off
red.
1 minute.
No.
No?
Well, yeah, the original pink was in both movies.
Yeah, the original pink was in. Oh, yeah, maybe not the original red.
Yeah.
The green. The white.
Get ready
Rangers
for time.
Okay,
Tommy
okay,
Oliver.
Hold on. Get time a second. Right, ready.
Time.
Got it. 1:13:11:45.
I got 1:13:10.
You won, Brandon.
Yeah, I beat my last record by a minute.
Anyways, yeah, the answer is Tommy was in both of them as a Ranger. Kimberly was in both of them, but and then because he was a Ranger in the second one, so was Adam. Adam was in both as a Ranger, and Rocky. He was a Ranger in the first one, and he was hospitalized in the second movie. He got injured in the second movie. That's how you replaced him with a little kid.
Yeah, and then all the Turbo Rangers, save for the little kid, end up going in space.
I was Shnick.
Even
was
the AVGM was mystified
minute.
By why they put the little kid in when he's in Ranger form, he's suddenly a teenager.
I was watching the Sentai versions of second season of Power Rangers, and the White Ranger, and that thing is a pervert. He looked at real skirts and stuff. Like he's a little kid, in the Sentai version, and he actually looked up this real skirt and grabbing her boobs.
Wow. Pretty sure they couldn't use that Sentai footage.
Yeah, Japanese.
Thank God it's over, and I won by a minute! Yeah!
What the hell?
Oh, that was a fucking headache, Vandilia.
But soon, the
whole we did it.
We'll know your record.
My personal record.
Next Saturday, Crash 3 race.
Yeah.
Anyways, I gotta go. It's super late.
See ya, Snick.
See ya. Wish me luck on my video project tomorrow.
Wish me luck on my video project tomorrow.
Yeah.
And then there were two.
Yep. And then soon this video is ending. Oh my god. Fuck it. We're gonna put a memory card in. And we're gonna save the game. Ugh. Jesus Christ, dude.
Speed run.
Oh my god, dude. That's amazing. I've been running this game nonstop for like 2 days, and this is the best record I've gotten. Fucking 1 minute 13 beats my last record of like 1:14. And hey, I shaved off an entire minute, so I'm happy about that. Thank God. Crash, fly to the moon.
Hope you all enjoy this series. You can check it out. You can watch it either on Brandon's channel or my channel.
Yep. All right. Goodbye.
Enjoy the randomness.